Welcome to the class, students. I am here to teach you chapter 4, matters and known matters. Let's warm up. Form group of 4 to 5 students. Look around the class, school and make a list of 10 objects that you see. Identify the material they are made up of. So students, you have to make the list like this. So you can do it by yourself. Let's know about matters and known matters. Physical and chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Uses of metals and non-metals. So students, these are the topics we are going to discuss in this chapter. We are quite familiar with the materials like copper, silver, iron, aluminium, gold, mercury, oxygen, carbon, nitrogen, iodine, etc. These materials have many uses in our day-to-day life. Some of the common uses of these materials are as follows. Copper is mainly used as copper wire and to prepare household utensils. Silver and gold are mainly used to prepare ornaments. Iron is used as iron wire, iron rod, iron sheet, iron nail and to prepare many useful items like khurpi, kachya, kudal, kulhari and many more. Aluminium is used as aluminium wire, household utensils, etc. Mercury is used in thermometers. Oxygen and nitrogen are the chief constituents of the atmosphere. Iodine is an essential constituent of table salt. All these materials are elements. So students, agar hum in sab materials ki baat kare, jo ki aap sab jante hain, hamare day to day life mein hum use karte hain, to ye sab kya hai? Elements. Now, we are going to read about elements. Elements are the substances which consist of only one type of particle, atoms or molecules. And cannot be decomposed into any other substances by any means like chemical reactions, cooling, heating or by electrolysis. Out of 118 elements known till today, 114 elements have been completely identified. Out of these, 92 elements are naturally occurring. So students, total elements hamare paas 118 hai, 92 naturally occurring hai. Now we have classification of elements. On the basis of properties, elements are classified as metals, non-metals, metalloids. Occurrence of metals and non-metals in nature. Occurrence of metals in nature. In nature, metals are mostly found in combined state mixed with many impurities. These compounds are called minerals. The minerals from which metals can be extracted conveniently and profitably are called ores. However, some metals like silver, gold, platinum and mercury are found in nature in free state. So students, these are some metals which found in free state. Now, occurrence of non-metals in nature. Most non-metals occur in nature in the combined state. However, some non-metals occur both in free state and combined state. Oxygen, nitrogen occur in free state in air and in combined state in Earth's crust. Sulfur occurs both in free and combined states in Earth's crust. The noble gases helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon occurs only in free state in nature. So students, ye kuch non-metals hai jo kis mein free state mein occur karte hain aur kuch kaise hain jo combined aur free dono states mein hame milte hain. Now we have properties of metals and non-metals. First, we are going to discuss about physical properties. Let's now study about the physical properties of metals and non-metals. The first we have appearance. Metals are generally lustrous, shiny, where non-metals are non-lustrous, dull. Here we have an activity, activity 1. Aim to compare shiny appearance of metal and non-metals. Materials required: a piece of sandpaper, copper wire, a piece of coal, a magnesium ribbon, an aluminium foil, a sulfur foil, a pencil lead, sulfur powder and zinc granule. So students, these are the things you need to perform this activity. Here is procedure: clean the piece of copper wire with sandpaper and observe it. Does it appear shiny? Now observe other materials one by one. Which of them have a shiny appearance and which are dull? So student, this is procedure you have to follow and you can perform this activity with the help of your teacher. Here we have observation and conclusion. You will observe that copper, magnesium, aluminium, zinc and silver are shiny. That means metals. A piece of coal and sulfur powder appears dull. That means non-metals. That's how you have to prepare the table. So students, metals kya hote hain? Shiny or non-metals shiny nahi hote hain. Look at this picture. Shining objects made of metals. Here, ductility. Ductility is the property that allow materials. Ductility is the property that allows materials to be drawn into wires. So student, ductility wo property hoti hai ki aap kisi material ka wire bana sakte ho. Electrical wires are made of thin strands of copper or aluminium, which are metals. The thin strands can be turned and twisted easily without breaking. This shows the ductility of metals. Can you think of drawing such thin wires from graphite? Definitely not. Graphite is a non-metal. It cannot be drawn into wires and therefore it is not ductile. Look at these pictures, students. Wires of aluminium, copper and gold. Metals ki jo property hoti hai wo ductility hoti hai, non-metals ductile nahi hoti. Now we have check and mate. You can do it by yourself as we already read about these things. Do you know? Gold is outstandingly ductile. This makes it useful for making jewelries. Here we have malleability. Metals are malleable. They can be hammered or beaten into very thin sheets without breaking. This property of metals is called malleability. So student, metals kya hote hain? Malleable hote hain. Aur ye property kya hai ki aap unhe hammer kar sakte hain itna very thin sheets mein jo aap unko kya kar sakte hain? Form kar sakte hain very thin sheets of metal. Wo usme break nahi hote hain. That is malleability. We get thin foils of metals because they are malleable. Gold, silver and aluminium are highly malleable metals. Non-metals are non-malleable. That means they cannot be hammered into thin sheets. Look at these pictures. Metal sheets. Now, chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Following are some of important chemical properties of metals and non-metals. The first we have electropositive nature of metals. Metals are generally electropositive in nature. That means metals lose one or more electrons to form positive ions. For example, look at these reactions, students. Now, electronegative nature of non-metals. Non-metals are generally electronegative in nature. That means non-metals gain one or more electrons to form negative ions. For example, look at these reactions. We have oxygen, electrons, after reaction, oxidants. That's how non-metal forms negative ion. Now, reactions of metals and non-metals with oxygen. First, reaction of iron with oxygen. At high temperature, iron forms ferric oxide with oxygen. Then, come to the next. Reaction of zinc with oxygen. Zinc, when strongly heated in oxygen, burns with a greenish-blue flame, forming clouds of light, zinc oxide, philosopher wood. So student, you can read these reactions from here. Reaction of metal with oxygen. All metals react with water to form metallic oxides. However, the reaction conditions are different for different metals. Following are the reactions of some of the important metals with oxygen. Look here. Reaction of sodium with oxygen. When sodium metal is heated with oxygen, it starts burning with golden yellow flame and forms the mixture of sodium oxide and sodium peroxide. Look at these reactions. These are the following reaction of forming sodium oxide and sodium peroxide. Come to the next, students. We have reaction of magnesium with oxygen. Magnesium, when heated in oxygen, burns with a dazzling white light, forming magnesium oxide. Come to the next. Reaction of copper with oxygen. Copper, when heated with oxygen, give cuprous and cupric oxide. You can look at these reactions. These are the reactions of copper with oxygen. Thus, we see that metals generally react with oxygen at elevated temperatures and form oxides of respective metals. The oxides of metals are generally basic in nature. Let's perform the following activity to show the basic nature of oxide. So, students, here we have some activities. Reaction of non-metals with oxygen. Non-metals generally form acidic oxides with oxygen. So student, non-metal kya form karte hain? Acidic oxide, or metals basic oxide. Here, reaction of sulfur with oxygen. Sulfur burns readily in oxygen to form sulfur dioxide. When sulfur dioxide is dissolved in water, it forms sulfuric acid. Come to the next, students. Reaction of phosphorus with oxygen. Phosphorus burns in oxygen to form phosphorus pentoxide. You can look at this reaction. Now we have an activity, activity 2. To show that metal oxides are basic in nature, hold a piece of magnesium ribbon with a pair of tongs and burn it in a flame. We know that magnesium burns in oxygen air with a white dazzling flame, forming magnesium oxide. Collect the as formed magnesium oxide, so formed on a watch glass. Look at this reaction. Now, dissolve a little of the magnesium oxide in water, taking a test tube and test with litmus paper. Does it turn blue litmus paper red or red litmus paper in blue? You will observe that it will turn blue litmus red. Thus, the nature of magnesium oxide is basic. In fact, all the metal oxides are basic in nature. So, student, you can perform this activity with the help of your teacher in your school laboratory. Here we have an activity again, activity 3. To show that non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature, take a small amount of sulfur powder in a deflagrating spoon and heat it. If deflagrating spoon is not available, you may take a metallic cap of any bottle and wrap in a metallic wire around it to give it the shape of deflagrating spoon as shown in figure A. Look at this picture. That's how you can use a deflagrating spoon. As soon as sulfur starts burning, introduce the spoon into a glass jar, glass tumbler. Cover the tumbler with a lid to ensure that the gas produced does not escape. So student, आपको क्या करना है, इस तरीके से आपको perform करना है कि gas जो है वो escape ना हो. Now come to the next we have, look at this picture, that's how you have to set your setup of this activity. Remove the spoon on the completion of burning, add a small quantity of water into the tumbler and quickly replace the lid. Seal the tumbler well, check the solution with blue and red litmus paper. So students, after this, you have to check the solution with blue and red litmus. Here, reactions of metals and non-metals with water. Reaction of metal with water. Metals generally form hydroxide or oxide with water. The reaction conditions are different for different metals. Following are the reactions of some of the important metals with water. So student, now we are going to discuss about the reaction of metals with water. The first we have reaction of sodium and potassium with water. Sodium and potassium react vigorously with water, forming metallic hydroxide and liberating hydrogen gas. So students, ये जो दो metal है वो क्या करते हैं, vigorously क्या करते हैं, react करते हैं और hydrogen gas release करते हैं. Now reaction of magnesium with water. Magnesium reacts with water. Magnesium react with hot water or steam to form magnesium oxide and hydrogen gas. Come to the next. Reaction of calcium with water. Calcium reacts with water at normal temperature to form calcium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Come to the next. Reaction of iron with water. Iron reacts and forms iron oxide and hydrogen. Then next. Reaction of zinc with water. Heated zinc reacts with steam to produce zinc hydroxide and hydrogen gas. Then reaction of copper with water. Pure water has no any action on pure copper at any temperature. However, copper gets clotted seawater. So student, copper jo hai water ke sath react nahi karta hai. Reaction of non-metals with water. So student, jo aapne abhi sab reactions padhi, wo metal ki reaction thi water ke sath. Aur un sab reaction mein ek cheez common thi ki har ek reaction mein hydrogen release ho raha hai. Now we are going to read about the reaction of non-metals with water. Non-metals do not react with water. Reactions of metals with dilute acids. Generally, metals react with dilute hydrochloric acid and dilute sulfuric acid to form the corresponding salts and liberate hydrogen gas. However, the rate of reactions are different for different metals. So students, agar hum baat kare metal ki reaction dilute acids ke saath, to wo salt ka formation karte aur hydrogen gas release hoti hai. We have some reactions of metals. You can read these reactions. Like the first we have sodium plus hydrochloric acid. After reaction, sodium chloride plus hydrogen gas. So that's how metals react with dilute acids. Here we have reactions of non-metals with dilute acids. Non-metals do not react with dilute acids. Also, non-metals do not react with water. Here we have reaction of metals and non-metals with bases. Reaction of metals with bases. Only some metals such as aluminium, zinc and tin react with a strong bases such as sodium hydroxide to release hydrogen gas. So student, kuch hi hamare metals hai jo react karte hai kiske saath, bases ke saath. Reaction of non-metals with bases. Reactions of non-metal with bases are complex. Here we have something. Reactivity series of metals. A series that lists metals in the decreasing order of their relatively is called the reactivity series or activity series. Metals which are higher up in the activity series displace those metals which are placed below them. Here is the reactivity series of the some commonly used metals. So student, agar hum reactivity series ki baat kare to wo kya hai? हमने नॉन मेटल्स को क्या क्या अरेंज किया हुआ है, वो हायर से अप, दैट मींस जो हाई नंबर पे है आपकी सीरीज में वो ज्यादा रिएक्टिव है, जो नीचे है वो कम रिएक्टिव है. लुक एट दिस, वी हैव अ रिएक्टिविटी सीरीज. सो स्टूडेंट्स, हियर वी हैव एलिमेंट्स, सिंबल रिएक्टिविटी. पोटेशियम मोस्ट रिएक्टिव, देन सोडियम, बेरियम, कैल्शियम, मैग्नीशियम, एल्यूमिनियम, जिंक, आयरन, निकल, टिन. टिन क्या है? इंक्रीजिंग रिएक्टिविटी. देन lead, hydrogen, copper, silver, gold, platinum. And platinum is least reactivity. Get it, students? Now we are going to read about displacement reactions of metal. A chemical reaction in which a more reactive metal displaces or pushes out a less reactive metal from its salt solution, then it is called a displacement reaction. For instance, when piece or a strip or iron is dipped in a solution of copper sulfate, the blue color of copper sulfate solution fades and the reddish brown copper metal particles are deposited on the iron strip. Here we have some reactions. Zinc displaces copper from copper sulfate solution. So students, agar hum copper sulfate aur zinc ki reaction karate hain to zinc kya karega? Copper sulfate ke solution se copper ko displace kar dega. Here iron displaces copper from copper sulfate solution. Why? Because iron zyada reactive hai kisse? Copper. Look here. Copper displaces silver from silver nitrate solution. Yes, because copper is more reactive than silver. Copper does not displace zinc from zinc sulfate solution as copper is less reactive than zinc. So students, copper kya karega? Zinc ko displace nahi kar sakta. Kyun? Kyunki copper less reactive hai. Get it, students? Now we have an activity. Activity 4. To show the displacement reaction of metals, take 4 200 ml beakers and label them A, B, C and D. Take about 100 ml of water in each beaker. Dissolve a small teaspoonful of each copper sulfate, silver nitrate, zinc sulfate respectively in each of the beaker A, B, C and D. So students, what you have to do, you have to take the beakers and water in these beakers and you have to mix the copper sulfate, silver nitrate and zinc sulfate in these beakers. Keep it for some time and observe the reaction in each beaker carefully. The process is shown in figure. Look at these pictures, students. That's how you have to make the solutions and that's how you have to wait for the for some time. Beaker A, copper sulfate plus zinc granule. Beaker B, copper sulfate plus iron nail. Beaker C, zinc sulfate plus copper turnings. Beaker D, iron sulfate plus copper turnings. Beaker A, zinc sulfate plus iron nail. Now students, you will see that in beaker A, a blue solution of copper sulfate turns colorless. That means zinc replaces copper from copper sulfate solution, forms zinc sulfate solution colorless, and the powdery red mass of copper is deposited at the bottom of the beaker as in the reaction first in the displacement reaction section. Now come to the second. In beaker B, blue solution of copper sulfate turns green as iron replaces copper from copper sulfate solution, forms iron sulfate solution green, and a powdery red mass of copper is deposited at the bottom of the beaker as in the reaction second in the displacement reaction section. Come to the next. In beaker C, colorless solution of silver nitrate turns blue as copper displaces silver from silver nitrate, forms copper nitrate solution blue, and the powdery silver white mass is deposited at the bottom of beaker as in the third reaction in the displacement reaction section. Silver nitrate is costly chemical and hence use very little amount. Now come to the next. In beaker D, colorless solution of zinc sulfate remains unchanged as there is no reaction taking place. That means copper does not displace zinc from zinc sulfate solution as in the fourth reaction in the displacement reaction section. So student, I think now you get it. What is displacement reaction and what is the work of reactivity series in it? Now we have Formation of rust on iron surface. Reaction of iron with air. Iron is not affected by dry air at ordinary temperature, but in moist air, it gets slowly rusted. Rust is a mixture of ferric hydroxide and hydrated ferric oxide. Here we have formation of green coating on copper surface. Reaction of copper with air. Copper is not affected by dry air at ordinary temperature, but in moist air, it is slowly converted into green basic carbonate. सो स्टूडेंट अभी आपने देखा कि जो हमारा कॉपर है और आयरन है वो किसके साथ रिएक्ट करते हैं मोइस्ट एयर के साथ नाउ वी हैव यूजेस ऑफ मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स यूजेस ऑफ मेटल्स गोल्ड सिल्वर एंड प्लेटिनियम आर यूज इन मेकिंग ज्वेलरी लुक एट दिस पिक्चर वी हैव गोल्ड ज्वेलरी यूटेंसिल्स यूज इन आर होम्स आर मेड ऑफ मेटल दे आर यूज इन मेकिंग एरोप्लेन्स ट्रेन्स शिप्स ऑटोमोबाइल्स एक्सेट्रा Metals like copper and aluminium are used for making electric wires. Silver foil is used for decorating sweets. Metals are used in making machines and electrical gadgets. Mercury is used in thermometers and CFLs. Metals are used in construction of houses, buildings, bridges, etc. So students, these are the some uses of metals. Here we have comparison of chemical properties of metals and non-metals. So students, look here, we have properties, metals and non-metals. Reaction with oxygen, metals generally form basic oxide. Non-metals generally forms acidic oxides. Reaction with water, metals generally forms oxide or hydroxide. Non-metals, no reaction. Reaction with dilute acids, metals forms corresponding salts. Non-metals, no reaction. Reaction with bases, metals only some metals react with strong bases. Non-metals, complex reaction. Here we have uses of non-metals. This is an abundance of non-metals like carbon, oxygen, nitrogen and hydrogen in nature. These elements are essential for the existence and subsistence of life. For example, oxygen is needed by living organisms for respiration. Water, which is the elixir of life, is formed by the combination of hydrogen and oxygen. Carbon dioxide, a compound of carbon and oxygen, is used to plants to prepare food. It also traps sunlight and keeps the earth warm. Plants need non-metals like nitrogen and phosphorus for growth. Generally, non-metals are bad conductors of heat and electricity. So they are used as insulating cover around wire cables and to make handles of cooking vessels, for example, bakelite. Diamonds are used extensively in jewelry and for cutting and drilling tools. Neon is used for electricity advertising signboards. Now we have check and made. As already we read about these things, so you can do it by yourself. What we learn in this chapter, now we are going to discuss it in a nutshell, elements are the substances which consist of only one type of particles, atoms or molecules and cannot be decomposed into any other substances by any means like chemical reactions, cooling, heating or by electrolysis. 92 elements are naturally occurring and rest are man-made. Elements having the property of malleability, ductility, metallic luster, and sonority are classified as metals. Elements which do not have malleability, ductility, metallic luster, sonority, etc. are classified as non-metals. Elements having the properties of metals and non-metals both are said metalloids. At room temperature, metals exist as solid except mercury, while non-metals exist as solid, liquid and gases. So students, here we have some keywords. Elements, substances which consist of one type of particles. Metals, metals are solid metal which is typically hard, shiny, malleable and ductile. Non-metals, a chemical element that does not have the properties of metal. Metalloids, an element whose properties are intermediate between those of metal and solid non-metals. Luster, the state or quality of shining by reflecting light. Malleability and ductility, the quality of something that can be shaped into something else without breaking. Brittle, delicate and easily broken. Sonority, the quality of having deep, pleasant sound. Conductivity, a material's conductivity is the extent that is allow an electric current to flow through it. Thank you, students. We will meet again in the next chapter. Till then, revise what we learned today.